What's, I think, great about these films that they've always stayed true to is not over-exploiting the alien side of things. You know, you'd see them in the deep background, but then occasionally you'd get sort of a close-up of one.
The first three Men in Black, all of the creatures were designed by a man named Rick Baker. Those characters in that context sort of get to the very heart of, I think, what's special about Men in Black.
They're among us mostly sort of in shadow or hidden, so when you see them, there is a wow factor to it.
There was one alien that we shot with yesterday, and it looks like he sort of has these mushroom-type things growing out of him, or like candles. He's like a candle chandelier, and it's awesome. He looks so cool. But that's what's great about Men in Black movies, is that you can really go for it when it comes to these alien designs.
Visual effects, we start working with them when we're done shooting. We start digging in with the characters when we start actually building the models and working with their textures and seeing them as 3D characters themselves. Of the characters we have up here on the board, several of them are going to be fully CG. So if it's an acting part, like Pawnee, the actor will be offset, but he'll wear a head-mounted camera unit. We'll have two cameras and lights, and he will actually act out and say his lines. So we'll actually capture his facial expressions, and that'll be embedded in the character himself when he's modeled and designed.
We do not kill Jababians nor participate in the murder thereof.
This is non-negotiable.